3D printing an energetic material, it's new, it's a novel material, it's something that hasn't been done before. 3D printing things so that you can get a third dimension. And then energetic materials is pyrotechnics, explosives, and propellants. There's many ways to do 3D printing. The specific one we're looking at is fused deposition modeling, where you are essentially taking a plastic, feeding it through an extruder, which heats up the plastic, and then you can deposit it wherever you want to create really any complex geometry that you're looking for. With energetic materials, there's some figuring out that you need to do because they are thermally sensitive. So to work with these, we had to find a thermodynamic sweet spot so that you can get the same reactivity that you're looking at. We've been developing that filament. It's essentially aluminum particles embedded in a fluoropolymer. The aluminum will fluorinate with the fluorine in the plastic, and then you'll get a nice robust reaction. And then we can use that filament with really any commercial 3D printer on the market. There's a lot of challenges with 3D printing, especially with new materials. The common materials like ABS and PLA, the settings have been figured out for two decades now. And so really where we come at is taking these new materials and finding out print speeds, layer heights, all of those settings necessary to be able to get a nice cohesive sample with minimal defects and pores inside, because with any part, defects and pores really can cause issues with the performance of your part. That is really one of the main advantages of what we are doing with energetic materials, is we're making them safer. We're able to make these parts safer because there's less human interaction, and that I don't need to be in there messing with the energetic material. I don't need to be in there getting hands on. I can set everything up, leave the room, and hit go, and then the printers do the work for me. Precision, you can print layers of 200 micron thick, 400 micron wide, so you can get down to really high fidelity. It took a lot of work with the settings, print speeds, in order to be able to achieve a very consistent sample. If you don't have a consistent sample from an energetic standpoint, your reaction won't be consistent, and therefore it's unpredictable. And so making these materials reliable to where whenever we hit go, if we hit go 10 times, we get the same part 10 times. And getting our settings, getting the configuration set up just right to where we know it's going to do what we want it to do, that was probably our biggest challenge. 3D printing an energetic material, it's new, it's a novel material, it's something that hasn't been done before. It's very exciting, it's very cool to be able to print these complex geometries.